That's my mom, Astrid. That's me, Alejandro.
Together, we travel the world to discover emerging artists with inspiring stories. Join us in our quest. Experience the art world as you have never experienced it before.
Bangkok, a city with temples, palaces, canals, busy markets, a population of 8 million, and a name that always gets my preteen cousins to snicker. It has been 9 years since my mom and I visited Bangkok. This time we're here in a quest to find emerging artists whose works can be part of a corporate art collection we're building for a Fortune 500 client back in the States. To get a taste for Thailand's contemporary art world, we decided to visit the country's most recognized art patron, Mr. Bunchai Bencharongkul, at his newly built museum, Mocha. Entering the building, we're greeted by a quote from the ancient Greek physician Hippocrates, "Ars longa vita brevis," art is long, life is short. In the center of it all is a statue of Professor Sitpa Virarsi, considered Thailand's father of modern art and the founder of the most respected arts academy, Silpakorn University. A sculptor who fled Italy during World War II and influenced a young generation of Thai art students who have become contemporary masters. Chai has collected over 1,000 artworks from Thai artists in a span of 35 years. Having minored in painting from Illinois University and having founded Thailand's second largest telecommunications company, Bunchai's resources are vast and his passion is endless. This road goes on and on. Sunset coming on, sunset coming on. Sunrise we'll see, but the sunrise we'll see again. Oh. Sunset coming on, sunset coming on. Oh, love, but the sunrise we'll see, but the sunrise we'll see. As our tour came to a wrap, my mom, girlfriend, and I cut across the road to see street art. For the past 15 years, more than 500 concrete pillars stand abandoned along the Bang Sue Rangsit Railway, part of a $24 billion project which failed to raise the needed funds. These pillars became perfect canvases for the street art community. Having Professor Silpa in our minds, we decided to travel outside of Bangkok the next day to visit his respected university and the future generation of Thai master artists. Before arriving at the university, we stopped at the studio of Pich Thangpon, an emerging artist whose artworks depict toys and happy childhood memories. Pich is a graduate of Silpakorn University and was introduced to us by our friend Fon, the owner of La Lanta Fine Arts, who will be our guide throughout the day's excursion.
I would love to just look around if you don't mind.
Yeah, you can. I'm scared of this is spicy, but Alex will take it.
I'll take it.
He's my guinea pig.
I'm the guinea pig.
He's not from this area.
Mm-hmm.
So he lives in Ayutthaya, which is north of Bangkok.
Ayutthaya.
And then
which is historical. That's where there's ruins and Ayutthaya.
Yes.
Right?
Yes. Okay. That's where he lived. When he was young, his dad come to this town to work. His dad is art conservator. So his dad come to work. So his mom bring him to visit his dad. And then he came and he play in the playground with merry-go-round. So that's what he did. Didn't even not realizing that, you know, now he come to this town again, but study art. So when he come to the town and study, that memory come back to him. And it to him is like awakening dream that, oh, I remember. I came here, was so happy. Then he started to do a series. The reason that he come to this technique that he work on brass is because he talking about memory. And he tried to figure out how to present that memory in the sense that it's so valuable to him. So that's why he go for brass instead of normal surface. He doesn't only use brass as it is. He use acid and then he use picture and then silk screen acid onto brass so that the acid has been eaten, because he talking about, of course, things in the past also go away with time.
Fading.
So he use acid on the surface that he used before he paint.
You know that I have a sad memory. Of toys.
Yeah.
Let me. I want to share with you a story. Now that we're eating together and my mom is here. When I was very young, my brother had come to the U.S. visited U.S. and came back and bought for me Ninja Turtles.
Ninja
Turtles. Yeah, you like Ninja Turtles?
Ninja Tao, yeah.
Who doesn't like Ninja Turtles?
Yeah.
Brought a hold, and it was with a car, and I had Splinter, you know, the rat.
Yeah.
And there, and then all the thing was the most amazing toy, and he brought it home, and I was so happy. And my mom, I wasn't a great student. I'll tell you this right now. And so my mom said, he likes this toy so much. Only when you get good grades can you play with your toy. I never got to play with my toy.
Oh, no.
In the end. About 8 years went by. I didn't do too well in school, and I never got to play with the toy. Can you believe it? And I want to bring it up right now so she remembers.
Oh, sad memory.
It's a sad memory. Can you do a toy of Ninja Turtles for us?
Next time.
He always feel that his work want to send out happiness. And so the toy that he used has no boundary. I mean, people who are not Thai can still understand his work and can still relate to what he's trying to say through his work.
So, meaning Ninja Turtle.
Ninja Turtle would
fits
work.
There.
Yeah.
All I'm saying is, think about it.
Yeah.
Ninja Turtles.
After lunch, we headed to Silpakorn University's sprawling campus, which caters to over 25,000 students. Before 1939, the campus used to be the grounds of Tapra Palace, just north of the royal family's Grand Palace. After World War II, it became Thailand's third government-sponsored university. We arrived to view the artworks from students presenting their master thesis. This is artist scouting at its best. That's just how my brain works. Just it is, oh, it is, 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 I know that. I know it sounds absurd, but we first met. The three-dimensional artwork representing the rural upbringing of Kritsada Dusadivani caught our eye, so we plucked him from his friends and had him share his artwork with us, of course, with Fun's help.
Visual art. It's flat, but then you use the space and the paint and the shadow to make it like illusion. But he want to create that illusion by creating the actual space. Aluminium, wood, and also paper as well.
Yeah.
And a rustic thing. He always interested in lifestyle. So what he wanted to do, so he moved forward from that. So that is more like a rural countryside.
Mm-hmm.
So now he moved forward to the lifestyle of people in the city.
Having viewed all the artworks, we decided to call it a day and visit the world's tallest stupa, which was about 10 minutes away from us, where the Nakhon Pathom Food and Fruits Fair was taking place. We said our goodbyes and we're on our way. A stupa is a mound structure containing Buddhist relics, typically the ashes of Buddhist monks who use the place for meditation. Next to every stupa, there are a row of metal bowls, which are for almsgiving, a way to pay respect to a Buddhist monk or nun and considered the beginning of one's journey to nirvana. The kids show me how to pay respect in a speedy procession. Now, diversity is a key word to describe the goods you find in a market here. Clothing, small animals, mid-sized animals, toy animals, big animals with impressive features, food, jewelry, garden ornaments, whatever you desire or not desire, they have it there. We decided to call it a day and rest for tomorrow's visit to a very special art community called V64. V64 is an art community comprised of 60 emerging visual artists who converted an abandoned warehouse 3 years ago into a beautiful complex with 4,800 square feet of studio space with an art academy, cafe bar, and sculpture garden. All of it funded by the artists, many of whom live in their studios and dedicate all their time to perfecting their craft and pursuing their passion. My mom and I were searching for respected artists from Thailand's street art world, and that is when we came across Sese, an artist who was born in Florianapolis, Brazil, raised in the countryside of Missouri, USA, and lives in Thailand with a family of his own.
My artwork deals a lot with multiculturalism, immigration, cultural clash, and things like that. And mostly just therapeutic for myself, so I feel that there's more justification of who I am. So it's an identity thing. So there's pieces of all the countries I've ever been, all the countries that I am inside of my work, but I'm not like locked in the four countries I lived in. The world nowadays, they always talk about globalization, everybody coming together, things like that, but in reality, everybody's just becoming the same, and it's all becoming like American, and pretty much like a popular version of what American is, pop culture, music, movies, all that kind of stuff. The United States culture, particularly like hip-hop and things like that, are all global, and everybody wants to be a rapper, even though they have no idea what like suffering is. This is an idea of like the idea of hip-hop that came from African-American culture in the United States, going back to Africa, but the Africans not having the means in which to participate the same level. He's got cigarettes, he wants to get some really cool, like, retro looking stuff for the 80s, but he ain't got it, so he super glued some cigarettes together. He's got a hat on that says TWA, that's a company that doesn't exist anymore. So obviously they're gonna send all their merchandise overseas, because who wants to wear a TWA hat when now it's American Airlines? And then to top it off, he's got the little like piece, but he don't have any bling, so he's got a mouse. Like an old mouse, because who uses a mouse anymore? Now we have notebooks and wireless. Who buys a wired mouse? So this whole idea that like he can replicate the culture that has been his, but then transformed and then given back to him, there's contradiction everywhere. And you realize that everybody's ultimately pretending to be something they're not. And everybody's a little bit like uneducated for how they're supposed to be. Nobody knows anymore about what their culture is, or even their language. We all speak bastardized versions of our languages. We all like have a watered down version of like our culture and traditions. And in a way, it's kind of cool because traditions are not really real; they change over time. But it's also kind of sad that everybody wants to just like leave their stuff behind. And a lot of times, I have to make compromises in my life where I'm leaving something behind just because I want to survive.
We continued our stroll and met Witayapi Sed, an artist who grew up tending water buffalo in the rural village of Nonclion. Witaya's corrugating iron canvases are a symbol of his people's agricultural roots. He has done well for himself and was packing for one of many trips he takes to donate clothes and accessories for kids living in rural villages. We sat down and heard his story.
After I graduated, my life it changed a little bit. I cannot pass the exam to work for the government in my countryside, like what I want to do when I first come here to Bangkok. Opposite my restaurant, I used to work when I was in university. There's a gallery, big gallery. And I know the people inside. I walk in and at that time, he need the people to help, like selling or cleaning. So I ask for the work. And I have a canvas and free paint. I started to paint.
So you pick up all these from houses that have yes. been turned down or what?
Yes. Yeah, where do you get the material?
Because it's all used.
Sometimes I buy from shop. Sometimes when I go around and I see the piece house. That I like, I buy a new piece to exchange. I use the material because you can see this material in every house, in town, in countryside. It's a material that people live. I use this for the symbol of the city. And the bird, it's acting like a people. Sometimes they are together, sometimes they are alone, sometimes they're happy, sad, just like us.
Looking away.
We have now is a problem of Thailand, you know, we are fighting.
So yeah.
In my opinion is we just like animal, just like a bird. Sometimes we are fighting. So please don't hate each other, it's just natural of us. Sometimes people think like, okay, we want to focus on fight. So
right.
It's nothing good.
Yeah. Right.
It's just natural.
We shift from birds representative of people to tattoos believed to bestow mystical powers. We're now in Bangdung Phon Rinkom's world. Yantra tattoos, also known as Sak Yant, which means to tattoo a sacred design, is an approach to tattooing that originated in Cambodia with the use of ancient script writing. During the Khmer Empire, all the Khmer warriors were covered up with tattoos from head to toe, including chest, arms, and even fingers, in the belief that the tattoos would protect them from harm and ward off evil and hardships. Rinkom's portraits are loaded with tattoos and layers of materials, oil, acrylic, charcoal, marker, that add to a subject's personalities and highlight a profound belief in the mystical world. After speaking with Rinkom, we head towards National Stadium, a major stop in the BTS Bangkok SkyTrain, to meet Chaphichai Promathadevi, a board member of the Bangkok Art and Culture Center. As we enter the center, there are similarities to the Guggenheim in New York with its huge white curving facade and spiral walkways. Art, music, theater, film, design, and cultural educational events have been occurring here since the center opened in 2008, 12 years after the idea was suggested. One of the main advocates to push for a cultural arts center was our very own Chaphichai, a managing director of a successful design company called ProSpace. He was kind enough to give us a tour.
You're standing on the 8th floor, and it's just happened to this exhibition, which is called Concept, Context, and Contestation. It's about works by nearly 20 Southeast Asian artists and about 3 curators, and they talk about conflict and contest and the demand within each of the countries. So what is inside here in this exhibition does reflect what's going on outside. You are here in Bangkok now, and hundreds and thousands of people in the street outside the gallery here. It's all shut down, lots of people. We are taking it into our own hands to see that the government is doing our thing. And in a sense, it reflects how this was built. We campaigned for this place for more than 12 years before it got built. During that time, we even had to take one governor to court for not building it. The art is very important. I think that art is something, especially contemporary art, is something you have to expand the meaning in your society. Culture is important. The government, the state, wasn't doing anything about it. So we had to do something about it. You know, we campaigned, and so it got built.
After playing with the interactive art, we head back to the BTS to reach our final destination, Chinatown. It was a Chinese New Year that evening, and we were not going to miss out. decided to try the express boat service on the Schoensap, an 11-mile-long canal which is used by 100 boats, each with 40 to 50 seats that seem to fit double the number of passengers. The canal is lined with concrete walkways on either side of it, and the boat drivers have little patience, which means you better jump on or find yourself another ride. We continued our journey by jumping on a tuk-tuk, an auto rickshaw, the result when a tricycle and a motorbike breed. It's not that sexy, but it's still a lot of fun and gets the job done. Tuk-tuks originated in Japan and came into existence in Thailand over 50 years ago. Its name was given from the rather rough sound it made and continues to make. At last, Bangkok's Chinatown, a popular attraction that has many shops selling food of all size, textures, colors, and smells. Oh yeah, they also sell gold, textiles, stationery, souvenirs, antiques, computer parts, pretty much everything you can imagine. Tonight, we celebrate the Chinese New Year, the Wood Horse Year to be exact, a time of fast victories and unexpected adventure. An excellent year for travel, the further away and off the beaten path, the better. A year when energy is high and production is rewarded. If all this is true, then my mom and I have a great year ahead of us, filled with unexpected journeys and fulfilling adventures. Till next time.